information we have already that we have a closed low out there, so this is likely to be upgraded to a depression. There's a reconnaissance aircraft in the area right now, and looking at those reports and reports from the islands, we're pretty sure we have a low there. This is Josephine up here, sort of at the top of your picture, actually possibly is going to go back to a tropical storm, minimal one. And you can see lots of moisture along the coast of Mexico there from about Mazatlan down to Manzanillo in the moisture train left by tropical storm Raquel as it moved inland yesterday. This is the latest information on Josephine, centered now at 27.9 and 40.1. And the winds are 35 miles an hour, and it's actually drifting a bit toward the southwest. We think that is going to be temporary, though, and eventually it'll move out to the northeast. This is that tropical wave, and you can certainly see just east of the islands here some very, very intense thunderstorms. Let's go ahead and put this into motion, and we'll share what the motion has been. This is what it looks like right now. And as we go back in time, you see it wasn't nearly so well organized earlier. Today, unlike yesterday, we see this concentration of thunderstorms pretty near where the center is. So this has got a good chance to go ahead and develop some more. It isn't moving much at all. It's kind of just drifting very slowly toward the northwest. We don't expect to see a lot of movement of it, but we have to watch this one rather carefully, I should think. Let's look at a blow-up picture where we can see it even a little better, and you can see some very massive thunderstorms. This is Dominica, Guadeloupe there, Martinique in that area. Some very, very heavy rain is going to be falling over the next day or so throughout the whole area. Now, north of Panama, east of Nicaragua, we have a few build-ups. Likewise, just east of the Yucatan Peninsula, but nothing much. Looking in the Gulf, nothing in the Gulf either. And there you see down around Cancun and Cozumel, some pretty good thunderstorms. But no kind of organization there. Now let's come back to the USA with Bill Keneally.
Thank you, John.
Dependable. Your local forecast from the Weather Channel. Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the 36-hour forecast. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Slowly toward the Leeward Islands, moving a little bit faster than it was. It had been moving about 2 miles an hour all day. Now it's about moving about six. It's within 50 miles now of Antigua, the center is. Up in the North Atlantic, we have Josephine, which is threatening to come back and be a hurricane. The winds are now up to 70 miles an hour now. Out here in the Pacific, we have some thunderstorms lined up, but no kind of a disturbance developing there. It's going to be a depression. Well, this is the latest picture of Klaus, and what we saw earlier today was that the center of circulation sort of became exposed. It got out from beneath these heavy clouds, and that indicated that it had at least steadied off. But in the last couple hours now, we see these kind of winding back around again, and we think that's going to allow this to strengthen some. So we would not be at all surprised to see this be a hurricane by tomorrow morning as it moves on toward the west. Let me show you what the latest particulars are. This based, we have a little bit of an update on this at 6 o'clock. Let me just read these coordinates for you. 17.0 and 61.0, and that is about 50 miles east of Antigua, moving toward the northwest or west-northwest at 6, and the winds are up to 60 miles an hour. Now, we haven't had a reconnaissance aircraft in the area since about 1 o'clock this afternoon Eastern Time. There is another one scheduled to go out there. It'll be out there about 8 o'clock tonight, and we'll be able to update you on what the pressure is at that time. We have hurricane warnings in effect from St. Martin's all the way down the chain here to north of Guadeloupe, and that includes Antigua, St. Kitts, Barbuda, Anguilla, and all those islands there, and then tropical storm warnings around the island of Guadeloupe itself. Nothing out now for the Virgin Islands or Puerto Rico. It's quite a ways from there. And at the rate it's moving, it's going to take a while to get there, but you want to keep track of it, and you folks over in the Virgin Islands of Puerto Rico. This is Josephine now, moving toward the north. Notice the winds are up to 70 miles an hour. It's actually forecast to go back and be a minimal hurricane, but we expect that to move out over the North Atlantic. Let me put this in motion for you just a moment, and you can see what the motion has been here. And again, the last couple hours showing signs of getting a little bit better organized around the center. And this is Josephine up here, and that's sliding off toward the north at about 10 miles an hour. Farther west we'll take you now into the Caribbean, and we have nothing there to be concerned about at all. Some clouds here, a thunderstorm just north of Cuba, and that's about it. The Gulf of Mexico looking mighty fine. And we have Typhoon Hattie, which is now approaching Okinawa. They're guessing they're better than 50 miles an hour there. In the next 12 hours, they expect winds of over 100 miles an hour. Now, here's Kevin Raymer.
Thanks a lot.
We came around early this morning looking at the satellite pictures, and then that was verified by the reconnaissance. It's not quite as strong as it was. It increased a good bit overnight. It was upgraded to a hurricane with 80 mile an hour winds. And on the last advisory, just out at 3 p.m., the winds have been reduced down to 75 miles an hour. Now, we don't see any evidence yet that this trend that we saw beginning this morning has ended. What is happening here is that the showers, heavy rain is all over here. The center of circulation is right there, almost entirely out from under where the heavy showers are. And this indicates shearing. There's some southwest winds at high levels, and they are driving the thunderstorms off to the northeast, and therefore the system is weakening. So we'll be watching that very carefully to see whether that trend is reversed. Actually, that happened last night, yesterday, but then last night it made a bit of a comeback. This is the latest position at 3 p.m., centered at 17.5 and 61.5. That's 35 miles northeast of Antigua. It is drifting now toward the northwest. It looks to us as if it may be going very close to straight north, actually, and the top winds are 75 miles an hour. And as you can see there, the barometric pressure, central pressure is up to 991. That is up from 985. There won't be another aircraft out there until about 8 o'clock Eastern time tonight to check it out. These are where the warnings are, but none of these islands from Antigua down toward Anguilla, Montserrat, none are getting anywhere near hurricane force winds at this hour. We have seen winds gusting to over 50 miles an hour at Antigua, and even those have decreased now. Still have Josephine up at the top of your picture, wind 75 miles an hour, but it's scooting up toward the north now pretty fast, northeast, about 16 miles an hour. We'll put this into motion for you briefly and show you what the motion has been. And that's what it looked like earlier, and now you can see the thunderstorms aren't nearly as concentrated as this circulation center is really out from under all these thunderstorms. Let's take a jaunt over to the west of the Caribbean, where we don't really have anything organized, nor do we have anything in the Gulf of Mexico that's of any concern. Hattie is now moving away from Okinawa. They're still gusting at about 60 miles an hour. The eye of the hurricane is expected to reach Kyushu Island in Japan in 24 to 36 hours. George?
John, time to talk about the 48 states. Pretty quiet weather. We've got showers and storms from around Naples, Florida. Another shower pocket up here in Maine into New Hampshire, and some showers south Texas, western Texas, and Montana through the Cascades. Some light rains and some snows over 7,000 feet. For the bulk of the country, it's dry. It's pretty warm, too. 84 in Chicago. Very high humidity there. Down to Dallas, 87 degrees, 91 in Grand Island, Nebraska. Pretty warm, 94 in the Phoenix area, and as you can see, the coolest weather up in the northwest and northern New England, too. 65 at Burlington, 55 limestone clouds, and a few showers around. Twin Cities at 79 degrees, high humidity there. Looks like a pretty warm weekend coming up, at least. Let's take a look at the afternoon map.
And really, it just literally sucked all that had been left of Klaus into the circulation. And Lili was downgraded from a tropical system because the circulation center didn't have any thunderstorms near the center, so that was declared extratropical. But we've been watching all day a low develop, and it's been over land in Cuba. We have some evidence now, both from the satellite loop and from the radar, that this low might be emerging from the coast. Now, the Hurricane Center is going to dispatch an aircraft down there tonight. It'll be late tonight, about 2 o'clock in the morning, a NOAA aircraft to see whether or not we already have a depression. And at that time, it may not even be too far from a tropical storm. We expect that to continue to move toward the west or west-northwest, but in time, say tomorrow, begin to turn more toward the north. So this is something that we might have to deal with in the Gulf of Mexico itself. In the meantime, it continues to shoot a lot of rain over Florida. The A lot of moisture from the remnants of Klaus, and this is all streaming toward the west, and we've seen winds gusting up to 40 miles an hour. This is causing some beach erosion there and some tidal flooding and some very heavy rains over Florida. But as this system begins to go to the north, it's going to spread the rain a lot farther north than what we've been seeing. This is Lily out here. Let's show you another satellite picture, and we'll put this one into motion. We'll look at the motion here for the last several hours, take you back in time. And here comes the remnants of clouds coming into Florida, and right in there is where we see a circulation developing, and we think that's getting really pretty evident there now. Let's take a quick look at the radar out of South Florida. Can we get the, yeah. And I believe that we can see some evidence now that the circulation center is just emerging from the coast here to the south of Key West. We'll be following that and letting you know. Let's go farther west now. There in the eastern Gulf, of course, you can see all this business emerging. This is a front in the west Gulf moving down this way. And in the Pacific, we have a tropical depression. Not a very big deal. Hasn't developed much during the day. Winds are 35 miles an hour moving toward the west at 14. Declan Cannon is up next.
Okay, thanks a lot, John.
As from the Weather Channel. Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the 36-hour forecast. Extended forecast. The current radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Bit of strength this afternoon, and maybe picking up even more. We had indications from the reconnaissance plane that the pressure had fallen about 4 or 5 millibars. The wind now up to 45 miles an hour, and it is not really showing very much movement either. It's gotten just about stationary, maybe just a little bit of movement toward the north, but it's also expanded quite a bit, and some of the rain bands, heavy rains, have gone inland now in the western part of Florida and the southwest around Marco Island and Naples. They've had some gusts up to about 47 miles an hour right there at Key West. So two things, it's expanded. That's caused the tropical storm warnings to have to be reinstituted here in the Keys all the way from Dry Tortugas over to Key Largo. Let's put a picture in motion for you, and we'll look at the motion now over about the last, say, 12 hours or so. And as we do that, we'll take you back in time, and here we are. We don't seem to have that motion, do we? Well, yes, now we do. I'm sorry. It's moving very slowly toward the north, I think, the last couple hours. And the movement has been really very slow, not very much movement at all. And let's go ahead now and see if we can take a look at the radar. Here's the radar over the last few hours. And the radar is basically showing us that it's getting better organized. We can tell that also from the Key West, because Key West is able to pick it up for us, and we can see it move a little bit toward the north each hour. But again, it's very slow. And we indicated that we've seen some pretty good rains come in. Now, we think the movement is going to be a little slow, perhaps not quite so far west as we thought it was. That might mean that this is going to be just a little bit closer to the coast. Let's go ahead now and look at the latest particulars, if we can. And here we are showing you the wind field. The gale winds extend out over a pretty large area, as you can see. And some gale force winds now have begun to impinge on the coast. We have that frame with the particulars on it. Maybe we can show you. Yeah, here it comes. This is based on the 3 p.m. advisory at that time, centered at 25.1, 82.6. That was 70 miles to the northwest of Key West, and it was stationary with 45 mile an hour top winds. Right now, it looks as if this movement is going to be mostly toward the north, very, very close to the coast, and possibly that will mean there's a chance of landfall a little bit farther south than maybe what we saw earlier. We're just going to have to wait and see how that develops. Farther on out in the Atlantic, we have Lily. That's a pretty good tropical storm. Not much concern yet, but it may be later because it is moving toward the west. Expected to continue to do that. It's about 1,600 miles now east of Jacksonville and moving toward the west at about 14 miles per hour. We have a storm out here in the Pacific with 50 mile an hour winds moving toward the west-northwest at 12. Tropical storm.
And across the U.S. First, we'll start you off with an update on old Marco. Marco moving up the west coast of Florida here. But Marco is really not the big story. The big story is this tropical moisture moving from the Bahamas into South Carolina and north into North Carolina and Virginia, just getting unreal amounts of rain from Charleston up towards Sumter and over towards the western Piedmont of North Carolina. Just very heavy rains there. Here is Marco moving up the west coast of Florida. Top winds now near the center of circulation down to 40, moving north at 9. If you're plotting, 28.3, 82.6, and that's just to the west-northwest of Newport Richey. Let's take a look at the radar for you right now, and we'll show you that rain spiraling around it. Some pretty heavy rains from this band right here, and they do have some flood warnings out for western peninsula Florida, as the rivers have been flooding with the very heavy rains here. Rains 3 to 6 inches in the past 24 hours. And as you can see, it's all moving north, and most of the heavy stuff right near the center, and we'll be watching that over the next couple of days, that is for sure. But there's your center of circulation just off the coast and moving northward. Now, as we show you more with our tropical storm, we can see the warnings in effect from Longboat Key to Apalachicola, and we are still looking for some high tides, 1 to 2 feet above normal. Don't know why we have Cedar Key there or Flamingo, because the areas of concern are from Apalachicola and down to about the Tampa Bay and Sarasota. Okay, as we take you out into the Atlantic, there is Lily, and you can see it's making a beeline to the west, moving at 26 miles an hour. Hurricane warnings out for Bermuda, but the strongest winds we have seen over the past 6 to 10 hours have only been gusting to about 50 miles an hour or so. But as the storm nears, we could get hurricane conditions within 12 to 15 hours. And with time, that could even affect the east coast of the U.S. As you can see, it is steaming in, and this could be a problem later on in the forecast. Right now, let's show you this afternoon's weather segment, looking first at our clouds in motion. Taking you to the Pacific, there's a lot of action out here in the North Pacific. Strong westerlies are developing a lot of energy, and we can see a front getting ready to move into the northwest. Pretty nice in the northwest today, but that will change tonight and tomorrow as this front swings through with rain and gusty winds. Another front moving out of the Rockies into the northern plains. That's coming to a screeching halt here. And with it,
Storm Simon out here in the East Pacific. Meanwhile, Marco is almost a fading memory. It has worked its way over land. It's now located over southern Georgia. And again, it's weakening quite a bit. But now our main focal point for today is Hurricane Lili out across the Atlantic. Here's another satellite vantage point of Lily, and we can put this into motion for you, and you can see how things have been changing somewhat over the past few hours. Again, Lily rapidly pulling off towards the west. Meanwhile, we have lots of tropical moisture feeding northward, spreading its way from Georgia into the Carolinas, and eventually this heavy rain will be taking aim on the Ohio Valley a little bit later on. Let's take a look now at the particulars regarding Hurricane Lili. Well, it's still roughly located about 485 miles southeast of Cape Hatteras, moving again quickly off towards the west at 22 miles per hour, and it's still packing winds of 75 miles per hour. Now, we're expecting very little change in strength for the next 24 hours, but we are expecting it to change its course. We are expecting it to be kind of deflected off towards the northwest and eventually more so towards the north. And at that rate, well, it could take it very close towards Cape Hatteras sometime Saturday morning. But as you know, tropical systems can be very erratic in nature, and it's hard to say exactly where Hurricane Lili will be tracking. But nonetheless, we have hurricane watches now in effect for the entire North Carolina shoreline, from Virginia Beach southward down towards Little River Inlet. We also have a heavy surf advisory in effect today, too, for the coastal sections of North Carolina. Meanwhile, in the East Pacific, Tropical Storm Simon, packing winds of 70 miles per hour, it's expected to move into some cooler waters, and with that, it should gradually weaken through time. Well, stay tuned. Coming up in the next few moments, we'll take a look.
Director Bob Sheets. Dr. Sheets, first tell me what concerns you most at the moment.
Well, the heavy rains there, of course, in the western part of North Carolina, that's some of the flash floods you're seeing for the moment. In the future, we have Hurricane Lili. It's just barely a hurricane at this time that will be approaching at least the outer banks of North Carolina within about 24 hours or so. And so we have a hurricane watch up for that area.
Damage and casualties from this unusual confluence of bad weather has been relatively modest so far. Do you see a greater threat in Hurricane Lili?
I don't think so. It's going to be barely a hurricane, if it's that, by the time it reaches the coast there. And indeed, that doesn't mean you have to have massive evacuations. Probably the greatest threat to life may be the flash floods that are occurring in the mountainous areas of western North Carolina.
The this confluence that I mentioned has been referred to, I think, by some of your people as a 100-year event, apparently something that takes place only once in 100. What does that mean?
Well, all of these things sort of came together. We had the remnants of Klaus, and then, of course, Marco traveling up the eastern side there of the Appalachian chain, and then a trough of low pressure, the front that's coming through. All those things are creating heavy rains for prolonged periods, and I think that's the big 100-year event you're looking at.
Is this a big story in your view?
In terms of the impacts of the heavy rains as you go up that coast, it's nothing like the Hugo, and certainly people should not be all that concerned in South Carolina or places like that. We really don't think that's going to impact that area.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Bob Sheeks at the National Hurricane Center.
Your local radar. But first, the current local condition. Today's regional forecast. Your local 36-hour forecast. Radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Hurricane Lili out here in the Atlantic Ocean. Let's set this into motion for you and let you see what it has been looking like over the past several hours. You can see it's continuing to work its way on towards the north-northwest now, so we're going to have to watch it as it's going to turn more to the north and skirt the eastern seaboard now. How close it'll be to skirting the seaboard is another story, but definitely the brunt of the storm system will be well offshore, so we're going to have to keep an eye on it and see how high the winds will be along some of the coastal waters. Now, let's take a look at some of the information now on Lili. Newest information just in from the Hurricane Center puts Lili at 32.8 north. New information now, 32.8 north. And 72.3 west. 72.3 west, still 75 miles per hour, and now moving towards the north-northwest at about the same speed, about 14 miles per hour, but it is now moving towards the north a bit more. And it looks like that the track will continue to parallel the eastern seaboard, and by early Sunday morning, we'll be several miles, we'll say 50, 60 to 100 miles off the shores of southern New England. So it's going to skirt northward and come like this. So we'll have to keep an eye and see how close it gets to southern New England around Cape Cod, Martha's Vineyard, Nantucket Island. Still a little too early, but it is turning more towards the north-northwest. We still have some tropical storm warnings in effect along some of the coastal waters of North Carolina and the inland sounds. Some of the tides may be about 1 to 2 feet above normal. 1 to 2 feet above normal, we've had astronomically high tides also, so some of the roadways near the beaches may be flooding or washed out. Tropical storm force winds not yet being felt along the Carolina coast. In fact, winds have been about 15 to 20 miles per hour. At times, really not that strong as the storm system still away from land a bit. As we check out the probability, still, we're lowering it now along the mid-Atlantic because it's going to turn more to the north now. As we take a look here towards parts of southern New England, 22, that means the storm system is going to come closer to this area than any of the others, as it will turn to the north and skirt towards the northeast. So how close it gets to southern New England, still a little too early to tell, but something to keep in mind, may see some winds increasing along parts of the New England coastal waters through Sunday morning. Rest of the tropics, really nothing organized out here in the Caribbean. The Pacific, we have a Simon out there, a tropical storm moving towards the northwest away from any major body of land.
Look at the Western Hemisphere shot. Still the weather fairly active down in the tropics. The tropical storm out here in the Eastern Pacific. Then we have Tropical Storm Nana out here in the Atlantic. Well, at last report, winds are around still 70 miles per hour, so a very strong tropical storm, and it's slowly pulling off towards the north. The latest reconnaissance flight, though, did fly into this tropical storm, and they indicated winds up to 110 miles per hour. So it may be that Nana's very close on the verge now being classified as a hurricane. We'll just have to wait and see for the official word. Here again is a satellite vantage point of Tropical Storm Nana. It may not look that impressive, but indeed, as I was mentioning, the reconnaissance flight indicated that winds were up to 110 miles per hour. Here's another satellite vantage point of Nana, and we can put this into motion for you. You can see how the system has been pulling off generally towards the north. Also, something to keep in mind is that we have a big trough of low pressure that's trying to work its way off the eastern seaboard. That may help to deflect Nana off towards the north. And if that's the case, well, it looks pretty good then for the lower 48, as Nana should stay clear of the lower 48. Now let's check out the weather across the Caribbean and the Gulf, where the weather remains fairly quiet. Here we have a front, though, sagging down through the northern Gulf, setting off some showers and some storms. Nothing of any tropical nature, though. And out across the East Pacific, Tropical Storm Trudy. This one we're expecting to intensify. It could be on the verge, too, of being classified as a hurricane. It's pulling off towards the west-northwest at 7 miles.
From the Weather Channel. Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the 36-hour forecast. Extended forecast. The current radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. Weather Channel. Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the 36-hour forecast. The current radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Up over Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico has flash flood warnings out again today. They've had several days of above normal rain there, and every day they get another batch of it. The ground is already saturated. So flash flood watches are out for the entire island. And we have Trudy out here in the Pacific, which is a hurricane. We'll detail each one of these one at a time for you. The information you see here was based on the noon advisory from the Hurricane Center, centered at 25.7 and 64.3, and that's 455 miles south of Bermuda, moving toward the north-northwest at 10 miles an hour, and the highest winds are 75 miles an hour. As we look at the wind field out there, we see that we have tropical storm force winds, thus winds 40 miles an hour or higher, extending out about 75 miles, farther out in the northeast quadrant than anywhere else. But that's still a long way from Bermuda. Now, this path that it seems to be taking, it's going a little bit west of north now. We think it'll eventually, by tomorrow, certainly turn north and northeast after that. Now, this may not miss Bermuda very far, so it could even go right over there. So we're going to have to watch that very carefully. Here's the latest satellite picture, and we can put a picture in motion for you and show you that, what the motion has been. And here we are, moving toward the north-northwest now at about 10 miles an hour. Still over 400 miles away from Bermuda. There are no hurricane watches or warnings out, but we may see a watch later, so stay tuned for that. And here's this wave coming into the Caribbean. It certainly has, approaching the Caribbean, certainly has some very heavy thunderstorms with it. And you can see farther over toward Puerto Rico, not directly affected, not directly connected with the wave, that we have some heavy showers as well. And these are the ones that are causing the flash flood watch to be in effect in Puerto Rico. Let's take a quick look out farther toward the east, and there we can see another look at that wave approaching. A big area of thunder showers out there, all that moving toward the west, about 15 miles an hour. Now, as we turn to the Gulf of Mexico, we have a front coming off the coast, and we have a tropical wave down here in the Bay of Campeche. No development expected there. On out in the Pacific, this hurricane is increasing, I think, by the hour. This morning, the winds were 75 miles an hour. I think that'll be quite a bit stronger than that in the next 12 hours. Moving toward the west-northwest at 7, 440 miles southwest of Acapulco, moving generally away from land. What else is going on here in the USA, Jim Cantore?
Well, John, we've had some hurricane...